make a reaction and then make the wrong decision.
Yeah.
His way that he adjusts is like, sure, yeah, aggressiveness and being overpowering against your enemy helps, but he's baiting his opponent to try to get out of those situations, and he's making the right reads.
Yeah, absolutely. He's got that pressure that he just puts on you. He's just standing in your face. He loves to be aggressive. Ever since Tekken 7, he's always an aggressive Jin. The card's already getting out. Here we go. Germany versus Saudi Arabia, Rife and Tetsu. Who's going to take it? Who's going to stay alive?
I mean, both of these characters, very strong, complete characters.
Yep.
They have a lot to bring to the table here, but will it be enough to overcome their opponent? Let's see what happens here. Game number one.
Yuki showed me a very funny picture just earlier of Tetsu practicing with Book and Rive sitting on the floor watching.
Let me study this.
Yeah.
All right, here, pushes forward and nice, gets the nice quick knee.
Yeah.
Good check there from Tetsu taking that first round.
And you know, Germany's had really, really solid Jin players in the past as well. So, is you know, matchup-wise, I think he's going to be very familiar with what to do versus Jin. But Rive, he's just such a hard code to crack.
Yeah, I think Europe in general, especially since the Tekken 7 days, has been really strong in terms of Jin play. Yeah, players like Daniel Mato, right?
Yeah, Daniel Mato.
That has been playing across the world.
Yeah.
But of course, Rive making visits there often helps as well.
For sure. Okay, 1-2-4. He's mashing into the jab strings. 1-2-3 and 1-2-4. Big healthy, but what a block. Is that dead?
It might be dead, especially if he does this properly. He does have heat, he does have rage. Is there the rage art? Does it? Oh my god. All right.
Well, I don't know about that one, but it worked out for him. Goes for the wild 74 for the Oki. Two rounds up here, Tetsu.
That's clean back-to-back rounds here.
Yeah.
Able to capitalize here. Doesn't check with the luck. And that's on the duck.
That's exactly what you were saying as well, right? The side steps from Rive are so on point. Talking about that though, Tetsu gets right to the back, but no punish.
Good use of the back four there to catch him. He clips him with the crouch edge one.
Yeah.
He's going to get a follow up here, pushing towards the wall, and he has the biggest right fist hitbox in the world.
Oh, that's so good. 1-2-4, mix up time, gets the game.
Oh!
I respect it, man. You've got to do something. Bam, bam.
Yo, he just took the momentum back, and he got a lot of his life bar. That's important.
Super! Wow. Oh my god, no way he's gonna make this comeback! Rage available! He can kill with a Rage Art!
Yeah, I think he might have it. I think he might have it!
Didn't even have to. Three rounds straight there. What a comeback! With one pixel remaining, Rive had one, like only one hit needed. Goes for the heat dash, plus five, and got Hopkins.
Hey, that move, down back one plus two, is so crazy.
It's so good. You know, minus two or something, yeah. Heat, you know, high crushing, mid. Launcher is so good.
I like when Akuma left the series, he gave gifts to everybody in the series. He's like, you know what? I'm going to give you this crazy Dragon Punch, Claudio. It's yours. Take it.
Oh, so we got the QATs coming up to give some coaching to Rive, man. The Middle East, you know, one scene right now all together here to help Rive. But this is exactly what happened last year as well, Mark, when between these two. You know, Tetsu won the first game, but then Rive was able to make two-game comeback. Is it going to happen again?
Yeah. Actually, great to be back here because, you know, we haven't had a master event in this region since 2019. So it's good to be back here and be able to see the community and the players from the surrounding areas be able to battle out against the players from around the world.
Absolutely, man. The passion here has been insane as well. And look at that.
Woo!
Amazing punish. Spring kick.
I like that. His use of spring kick to kind of get out of there and mitigate the risk here at the wall. Ooh. Man, look at the damage piling up.
Optimization. Hang on. Down jab. Oh, what a back dash.
He went for the nip up and there's the punish. Here we go. Rive. On the scoreboard, taking that round, you know, I feel like he got robbed in some of those rounds in the previous game. But let's see how he's able to adjust here and be able to use this momentum. Because Rive with momentum is scary. But yeah. That's the second time you went for that poke there. The back forward 2-1, the second hit being high. This time Tetsu ready for it.
Yeah, you can't test Tetsu when it comes to this stuff, man. Goes for that stage interaction, big blast, and big combo as well. Has Starburst available. Down back 1+2, our favorite move. Bam,
great.
Bam, bam.
Able to get the wall here. Hey, puts him in a reset situation. Goes for the heat smash.
Yeah, shades of Morgul there. Loves to use that heat smash low. Does a lot of damage at the wall. One round apiece, the second game.
Yeah, let's see what he goes for here. Nice. And Rive again, just using that movement to his favor here. Trying to create opportunities, but hey, Tetsu ready there. Gets the big launch. That's an important one.
Yeah, he's definitely using his movement as well. Tetsu, the lateral movement, sidestepping in. A big punish. Look at the combo as well.
Ooh, and he gets the follow up on the Oki with the shoulder.
Okay, he activated. He's got rage available. Oh, that's going to be a counter hit. 1+2 guarantee.
Did not go for the heat dash cancel afterwards.
Uh-oh. Mix up time. Dive kick.
Yo, this is going to hurt. One more mix can do it. He gets him with the mid. Rive moving on. Two rounds to one here.
One thing about Tekken 8 I love is you never know when the round's over. Like, we've seen so many times, you know, if you can get that one heat engage, that one interaction, it can really help you to win. You just got to steal that momentum.
Good punish here. Rife with continuing that momentum, uses the crouch out cancel afterwards, trying to poke away, but I like the throw here from Tetsu.
Yep.
Get some great positioning here. Now going to start some of his offense.
Okay, goes for the heat burst. What's going to be the pressure? A lot of chip damage being dealt to Tetsu at the moment. Rage available. Tetsu now has access to heat.
Opts to use the heat there. Keeps him by the wall, but Tetsu still having access here. This time with the heat dash cancel, goes for the knee, the follow up, and he's going to have the wall combo. What does he do though?
Wow, look at how high you've been.
Wait a minute. Damage. Look at the damage. Oh my gosh.
The okay, look at that. Tetsu now moves onto set point. Is Ryve's run going to come to an end here at Emirates Showdown?
Saudi and Germany battling here. Very important match. This is an elimination game, and it could be elimination round. Let's see what happens.
The whip punish. Amazing. Tetsu going to be able to take to the wall. Doesn't get walls back though, unfortunately. Running two.
Great use there.
Is this going to be it for Rival? Can he make another comeback? Good punish. Uh-oh.
Oh, the pressure at the wall here. He has access to heat. There it goes. He pops it.
Catches the sidestep. It's on. Nice sidestep. Duck Tetsu! Is this going to be a caddy kill here?
He might be able to. He should be able to.
Oh,
the wall wasn't there!
And the jab low. Tetsu going to get his revenge over Rive, taking him out 2-0. And Rive's run comes to an end here in seventh place at Emirates Showdown 2024. But Tetsu moving on. And like I said, he needs those points. But right now, you can hear the crowd chanting for Rive as well, man. You know, this is someone that's been representing the Middle East so well around the world, Mark. And, you know, they have a lot of respect for him.
Yeah, great stuff, of course. Love.